Good morning, students. Today we are starting next chapter in science, chapter 11. The name of the chapter is measurement. So let's begin with measurement. Students, we need to measure many different things in our daily lives, right? If we talk about our day-to-day lives, we know that there are a lot of things which we need to measure. For example, if you have to travel somewhere, if you have to go, you will have to know the distance. Yes, the distance from one place to another. If we have to measure a height of a person, if we have to measure the weight of something, for example, if you have to buy the fruits and vegetables, so you will tell that vegetable seller that I need 1 kg of potatoes. You will tell that I need 2 kg of tomatoes, like that, right? So in this way, you are telling that how much do you need, yes? And then he will weigh that, if you are buying potatoes, he will weigh potato and then he will give it to you, right? So in this way, we are weighing this measurement, okay? Then if we have to say, suppose buy a packet of a milk, okay, then you will have to tell the shopkeeper that I need 1/2 liter of milk, I need 1 liter of milk. Yes, in this way you are telling your requirement that how much do you need. Okay, so these are those measurements which are required in our day-to-day lives. Okay, now here something is being measured in each of the following pictures. So you can see here in these pictures that something is being measured, right? You can see these machines which are helping us in measuring, right? You can see these machines. I'm sure you must have seen 2-3 machines also, which we use to measure something, right? So children, we talk about, if we travel back in time when there was no concept of measurement, the people at that time, they used hand span, they used foot span, they used cubit, okay, for the measurement, because they did not have any as such machines which helped them in measuring these things, right? So if we talk about a hand span, you can see here, with the help of a hand span, they used to measure, say, suppose if they have to measure a length of a table, yes? Then here you can see how measuring with a foot span, yes? Again, measuring the length, yes? Then again, measuring the length with the help of cubit. Now, cubit is from the top of your this finger and till the end of elbow. So that is the cubit, right? So since different people have different size, yes? So these measurements, they can vary, right? It may be possible that your hand is small and my hand is big. So then again, the measurement in this way can vary. We will not get the accurate measurement, right? You can see here. So that's why they are called as non-standard units of measurement, okay? Hand span, cubit, foot span, if you are able to measure, but again, you will not get the accurate measurement, since the size of hand, the size of leg can vary from person to person. That's why we call it non-standard units of measurement. Now, when we talk about the standard unit of measurement, so the standard unit of measuring, you can see here, what is a unit? A unit is the smallest quantity of something that we can measure. Okay, when we talk about the standard measurement, standard unit of measurement, we can say that we need standard objects and units for making the measurements. So what are those standard units? We can see here in the picture. If we have to measure a length of any, suppose we have to measure the distance, right? So with the help of length only, we will be measuring the distance. Now the units here will be kilometer, meter, centimeter. You can see these are the units to measure the length, right? Similarly, when we have to talk about how heavy an object is, we have the units kilogram and gram. Okay, when we have to know that what is the capacity, right? How much milk is there in the mug? How will you know that? The units to know that, to know about that, liquid is liters and milliliters, right? Here in the picture you can see, how will you know that how much distance a car has traveled with the help of the units? How much is the weight of a child with the help of the unit? How much is the juice in the bottle with the help of the unit, right? So that's why we tell this, we call it the standard measure, the standard unit of measurement, right, children? So now, units to measure length. Okay, we will be starting with the length. You can see here in the picture, if I say that you have to measure your height, so how are you going to do that? Are you just going to measure your height with the help of that small scale or small ruler which you have? It would be very difficult, yes? So we require those measuring tapes which are available to measure the length. Okay, so in measuring length, children, length tells us how long something is. With the help of length, we come to know how long something is. Okay, for example, you can measure your book and you can come to know that how long your book is. Yes. And when we talk about the standard units of length, the standard units of length are centimeter, meter, kilometer, right? And you can see 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeters. 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. And 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters, right? So in this, you can see these, you will be needing this when we will have to convert, right? When we will have to convert the units. Yes, we will be discussing it later on. So with the help of the length, children, we come to know that how long something is, and we use a ruler, we use a measuring tape, or we use sometimes a meter rod also to measure the length, right? Now here, let us see what is happening here in this video. Here you can see there is a man who wants to measure a paper. So how are you going to measure a paper, children? With the help of a ruler, right? So with the help of a ruler, we can measure. In the ruler, if you see, there are small and long lines. Yes, those longer lines which you see, they represent the centimeters, right? And the smaller lines in between, you can see they represent the division of centimeters. Okay, so if you have to measure, say suppose 2 centimeter, then in a ruler you will see, you will find 2 centimeters, then 1/2 centimeter. You can see this is an example of 4.5 centimeter. With the help of ruler, we measure in this way. If you have to measure pencil box, your book, eraser, again you will be requiring the ruler to measure these objects, right? Now rulers are of different shapes and different sizes. So you can see here that it is 15 centimeter long ruler, then there is 30 centimeter long ruler, and a ruler cannot measure all objects. Say suppose if I have something which is very long, are we able to just measure it with the help of a ruler? These objects which you can see in the picture, which are short and small, these are measured with the help of ruler, and with a measuring tape we have to measure long things. Now see here, if a woman has to buy a sari, then the shopkeeper will be measuring the sari with the help of a ruler or with the help of a measuring tape. You know that the sari is really long, isn't it? So the shopkeeper will have to use that measuring tape or a meter rod, which is longer, much longer than the small, that usual ruler. Yes. So the shopkeeper will use that to measure those long clothes. Okay. 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters, right, children? You should remember this, that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. Okay. Now it was about length. When we talk about measurement of mass, right? So measurement of mass, you can see here, mass tells us about how heavy or light an object is, right? If you see here, say suppose if you are going to buy fruits, yes, then you will be needing that how much weight is required by you, right? Then with the help of mass, you also come to know what is heavier and what is lighter, right? Then mass is the measure of how heavy or light a thing is, right? Different things have different masses. Mass of lighter things is measured in milligrams or grams. Okay, so here you can see, children, there are the units of mass which are given, and when we have to measure, the lighter things, then we will be measuring those small masses, smaller masses, in grams or milligrams. Okay, milligrams is represented as mg and grams is represented as g. Okay, and mass of heavier things are measured in kilograms. Okay, you can see here kilograms, and it is measured as kg. Okay, it is written as kg. So mass is measured by using a weighing balance. You can see this picture, children. It is a picture, it is an image of a weighing balance or an electronic balance. Yes, you can see here it is an electronic balance machine. We can, you must have seen this in the shops, wherein the shopkeeper just keeps that thing which you want, and the weight of that particular thing will come here. You will be able to see the weight on this screen. That's why it is called as electronic weighing machine, right, children? In this picture, you can see again, it is a picture of a weighing balance, and how still this machine is used to measure the weight of something, to measure the mass of something. In this picture, you can see, you must have measured your weight also in this type of machine, right? Which we use to measure our weight. Yes. Now, units of measure, as we have discussed, children, 1 gram is equals to 1000 milligrams, and 1 kilogram is equals to 1000 grams. Okay, children. So now the next example you can see here in the picture, the help of that weighing balance machine. Now you can see here that this is the weigh of which is 500 grams, and here I have kept one apple, and you can see that it is now equal. So that means an apple weighs 500 grams, and here you can see a chocolate will weigh how much? It's 100 grams, right? So this is how we measure the mass. Now children, whenever you are going to buy something, or you can just ask your mother to show those packets which are available at your house to see the measurement on those packets. On those packets, you will always get to see that here, somewhere here, you will be seeing that what is the weight of that particular thing. For example, you can see in this packet, here it is mentioned 150 grams. Yes, so that means the weight of this packet of peanut, it is 150 grams, right children? You should always see the back part of this packet, wherein it is mentioned that when is the expiry date of that particular product. Yes, and you get to know the price of that thing, how much cost. Then here you can see the nutritional values also, right? So this was all about